Right now, Joe Biden revives the gun control debate, or at least tries to, and warns foot-dragging lawmakers they will pay a price for inaction. Do you believe him? And next, the National Security Agency tries to defend itself, saying that all the snooping they've been up to has been worth it. More than 50 terror plots have been thwarted, they say. But do you believe them, and does that make it okay? And later, is the bromance over? Governor Chris Christie slamming President Obama today, saying his failure to lead is showing. Guess those long walks the two of them had on the beach are now a thing of the past. Good evening and welcome to RFL. I'm Andrew Whitman in tonight for Richard French. Thanks so much for joining us on this Tuesday evening, June the 18th. Vice President Joe Biden spoke from the White House today in an attempt to revive the fight over gun control. He made clear that the administration is not prepared to give up the fight.
We need Congress to act. The American people are demanding it. As I've said before, we need to make sure the voices of those we lost are the loudest ones we hear in this fight. We need to make sure that everyone in the country knows that this fight isn't over. Far from it. The country has changed. You will pay a price, a political price, for not getting engaged and dealing with gun safety.
To demonstrate the White House's commitment to the issue, Biden announced today that the administration has completed or made progress on 21 out of 23 executive actions produced by a gun violence task force that Biden spearheaded after the shootings in Newtown. The executive actions were issued by President Obama back in January. So at this point, is there any hope for gun control in the immediate future, or has the moment just been missed? Let's bring in our panel on this for the evening. O'Brien Murray is back with us tonight, Republican strategist. Dominic Carter, political journalist and author. And Richard Brodsky is here, former New York State Assemblyman, senior fellow at Demos and professor at NYU. So is there any realistic chance? Let's just say background checks, the one that couldn't get through in April. Is there any realistic chance that that's going to get done by the end of the year or in this Congress?
No, because the crazy people are in charge, and the crazy people are repeating the mistakes of 2010, and the crazy people dominate the Republican Party.
Richard, you can't keep on saying crazy people.
That's not the point.
But I was going to agree with them, O'Brien, and I really was.
Well, no, I agree with the first comment he said, that first sentence. After that, I didn't. It's not going to happen. We all know that. Okay, we got that. Once you got beyond that, you went a bit too far.
Well,
what's happening here is
they're going beyond
background checks on this stuff. If they stuck to just background checks and didn't keep on trying to do everything else, it would be a lot easier to get something through.
Didn't go anywhere.
They didn't go anywhere either. This is you talking, not the crazy people in Washington, D.C.
Well, you're not calling me crazy. That's nice.
There's hope for all of us.
I agree with them. So
this is, as Biden said, going to play out in election terms. With all the Republican gerrymandering, there are people who are insulated from that problem. They're only worried about primaries, so their political price is going to be hard to notice. But in the end, the American people are going to demand intelligent, moderate, sensible response to the gun violence problem. And watch this. You people are going to have a lot of trouble.
I'm not going to let that one go. First off, last I checked, there's no gerrymandering in the U.S. Senate unless they're moving state borders. Okay, this has not gotten through the U.S. Senate that the Democrats control. At this point, I don't see it going through there. You're talking about the House. We're not even in the House yet because Reid can't get his people together and get this thing passed.
You expect the Democratic Party to be a monolith and have everybody vote for it, in which case they still don't have 60 votes to get past the filibuster.
You're making it up. It's part of reaching across the aisle and getting other things done.
You're getting a little to the crazy side.
Because you had Pat Toomey there leading the charge as well. So you had people from both sides of the aisle trying to work on this. When they tried to put other things on the bill.
90% of the Democrats voted for it and 10% of Republicans.
But they didn't even get Reid couldn't even keep his own people together on this.
This is spin.
What about Biden's claim that there will be a political price to pay for those who vote against gun control? Does anybody believe that?
Well, it obviously all politics are local, and I think that's what Richard was saying in terms of, and it's remarkable. I agree with everything that he said
just
tonight.
Just because it's your birthday, don't start pushing the envelope. What were you saying? Answer the man's question.
Now I know why Dominic's been in a good mood all day.
There you go. The man is a genius.
What's in that glass tonight?
Can't tell. But no. But he's right in terms of. And I call them nuts in terms of the Tea Party folks. As long as they're around and as long as the NRA is around, I just don't see it coming back this year. One has to hope that the vice president is accurate and that there will be a penalty and a price to pay.
Dominic,
but in certain districts, I'm done in 10 seconds, in certain districts across America, they will be rewarded for screwing Americans and not bringing in gun control.
O'Brien?
You guys are using words that are divisive. You've got to bring people together.
Wait a minute.
You can't call people.
And how do we do that?
First off, you don't start name calling like you're doing, like
when
Richard's doing.
When a Republican starts telling us we all have to get together, I worry.
That's,
you know, I don't doubt you believe it. Have you spoken to anybody else
Richard,
in your party?
You've got to get out of the mentality of an assembly that's controlled by Democrats doesn't need Republicans.
I see.
You've got to get out of the Albany mentality, and you've got to get people together.
Fault.
It's not your fault.
It's my fault. But are you?
If I could blame it on you, Richard, you know I would. But I can't blame it.
Really, are you really saying that, you know, if they just held hands and sang Kumbaya, would they be able to get some bills passed?
I'm saying that's the first start. This goes back to what Christie said today about Obama. We're going to talk about later, possibly. But the point is, if you want to go along, get along, and agree on things, you've got to work together. And I've said this before on this set and other shows.
Define working together in this example.
Well, first off, don't get into name calling.
Okay, and what's the next thing? And what's the next step?
The next step is when you're going for something like background checks, keep it at background checks and don't go beyond it. And when they try immigration, they try to go beyond
they
background checks.
They did that and they lost.
Right.
You're at a loggerhead here because you've got the Democrats who want the background checks and you've got mostly Republicans who don't want the background checks. They can call each other whatever nice names they want to call each other, but you're still,
not even calling each other nice names. They're trying to come after each other. And if they're going to come after each other, they're not going to say, okay, fine, I'll vote for it even though you're calling me names.
It Congress doesn't work that way. Don't vote because somebody strokes them. They vote because they think something is right or wrong or because it's politically possible or politically desirable. This notion that what's standing in the way of gun control is a mood change is just, with all due respect, Bushwalk.
Who knows what's coming next?
All due respect, let me get my last question before we run out of time. If we don't think that this is going to happen anytime soon, what was Biden doing today at this whole event? Why even schedule this event to tell us that he hasn't even completed everything that the president wanted to?
Ratcheting up the political pressure, which is what leadership does in some circumstances.
It's pressure, it's leadership, it's 2016. He's on the short list right now for the top of the Democratic Party right now for 2016.
Do you think this is Biden looking after Biden?
Not only that. I mean, first off, his communications director is a magnificent woman. She's my cousin, and she does a great job of what she's doing with him. But beyond that, he's been putting a record out there for what he's trying to accomplish in this administration and get credit for it. And it's, what happened in Newtown was a tragedy, should never have happened. We all agree on that. And unfortunately, history has shown us it's going to happen again. And I think what the administration is doing here is making sure they're putting a stake in the ground and saying, we want to move forward and get this done. And they're going to have the stake there. It's going to sit there. And God forbid something else happens again. God forbid. And they're going to be out there again trying to push this thing. And don't forget, the day of Newtown and that tragedy, the president spoke out that day about gun violence. Instead of just embracing the families, he went right away on day one and went political.
But wait a minute. And I know we got to take a break. But didn't the families want to address the issue of gun violence?
They've been talking about it ever since.
They didn't just make this up out of thin air.
The families are fantastic individuals and as a unit speaking out for it. What I'm saying is on the day of the tragedy, the president spoke out.
I forgot. That's a Republican rule. I forgot. Richard, I hope you're ready for this one. Whenever there's a tragedy, gun violence, you're not allowed to discuss it on that same day because that's politicizing the issue. Democrats are not allowed to do that. We've been hearing that for a while. So whenever there's a tragedy,
also point out Benghazi, the day of Benghazi happened, terrorist attack, whereas under George Bush, it was, you can't politicize it.
Well, let's go back. I'm happy to talk about that, but your question was, why is Biden doing this? What I'm saying is they're putting a stake in the ground and saying this is where we are, so they can always come back to it.
We can do more than one thing at a time. Biden was doing politics. He was doing leadership. He was doing institutional pressure. It was a good thing.
If only everybody was just nicer to each other, that would solve so many problems.
I'm telling you, I've said this before, Washington pre-94 was a much different place. And when the Democrats lost power and they didn't hang around with each other on the nights and weekends, it's changed quite a bit.
We're going to get back into
and Willie Horton. We're going to get back into
the style and the can't everybody get along argument in a little bit. But we want you to keep this conversation going online. Head over to our Facebook and Twitter page to sound off. Has the White House done enough to push for gun safety? Up next, the National Security Agency defended itself today against critics that say its snooping program helped foil several terror plots. Does that make you more comfortable with what they're doing? That's next on RFL. Stay with us.